introduction of the laws of motions. Okay, the suppose let us take a ball and throw into the air. What happened? Again it is coming to down. Why it is coming to down? So means then why it is coming to means some force are there, some power is pulling to down. Due to that it is coming to down. What is that pulling power? Then that power is said by the Newton is the scientist. Actually the force is discovered by the Newton. Simply one day, one fine morning day, simply he is taking rest under the apple tree. Then he observed. What he could have observed? Apple, the ripe and ripe, is taking rest under the apple tree. So apples, after ripened the apple, it is coming to down. Okay, then he is thinking, okay, why this apple is coming to down? It can go up. Also, but why it is coming to down? Then he started the investigation on that. Okay, finally he said about the some force is there. What is that force? Then he started the research. Finally he could give the conclusion that okay, some force is pulling to down. That force we can say that is the gravitational force. Gravitational force. Then that's why we can say that is the the first said about the force is given by the Newton. Then we can say that is the Newton. Then Newton is given laws. Newton also given us to some laws. There is a Newton first law will be there next, and there is a Newton second law, and the Newton third law also will exist. Okay, we will discuss what is the Newton first law and what is Newton what is the Newton second law and what is the Newton third law. One by one we will see. First we will see about the Newton's first law. Next heading. First one is introduction. Okay, first part is introduction, already I completed. Next one, Newton's first law. Okay. Newton first law. This law is given by the Newton. That's why we are calling that is the Newton first law. Okay. Why the what tells us about the Newton first law? Suppose there is a one object. There is a one object or there is a one some system or so whatever. Okay. If there is no external force on this object, it wants to be at the same place. Or else if one object is moving in one direction, okay, always it wants to be move. One object is at rest position, always it wants to be same position. Or else we can say direct one definition, the object is wants to, suppose object is moving means it wants to be in the moving position. If object wants to rest position, it always try to be in the rest position. If there is no external force, then we can say that is the Newton's first law. So Newton's first law tells about the inertia also. Or else we can say another name of the Newton's first law, inertia. Inertia means, let us take best example, if you take the door. If I apply force, what happen? If I apply the force at the end, then it also move. If I apply the force down also, it will move. If I apply the force, okay, the door will move very slowly. So the door is fixed at one end. Then what happens? Simply it is moving. Then we can say that door, the force is acting. That force we can say that inertia also it is there. So what is the Newton law? Exactly, first law means the Newton first law tells about the inertia. Always the body tends to be in a same state until and unless there is no external force. That is the Newton first law. Okay, there are many examples will be there, Newton according to Newton first law. Let us take one person is there simply sitting on the bus. What happened? The sudden jerk will happen. Then what happened? The person will move and again it is coming back. Why? What I said, always the body is try to be in the same position. Previously, see, before jerking, what happened? The person is simply sitting on the chair. Okay, as soon as jerk come, what happened? Event forward and again it is coming back. Actually, what is his initial position? He is simply sitting in the bus. Okay, that's why after coming the jerk, then it is went front end, again it is coming to back. Like this, and there are many examples will be there. So that is what is the main here Newton first law tells about has means Newton first law tells about here only inertia. Next one is very very important, Newton's second law. So what is the Newton's second law? So the external force, suppose if object wants to move, means what you need, definitely you need, see what is the topic name actually, motion. When the object will be motion, definitely you have to apply some motions. Okay. Without applying force, is there any object will move automatically? No, in this world there is no chance to move any object without external force. Okay, that may be different, but that may be nuclear force, or that may be our human being force, or that may be nuclear force, or different force, gravitational force, electrostatistics force, different. Without force in this world, there is no moving object. Let us take pan is there. Suppose if pan wants to move, what we need actually, electricity need. Electricity also one kind of force. So anything wants to move, then we need some force. Okay. So what tells us Newton second law? Okay. The Newton second law tells us here. Okay. If you apply the external force, I will write here. What is the definition here? The external force is acting on the body, it is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Okay, what is the definition? The Newton second law tells us the external force acting on your body, it is directly proportional to the, what we can say simply here, directly proportional, this symbol, directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Then we are calling that is the Newton second law. Okay, we can write this Newton second law in the mathematical form. What we can write, see, what is there? External force, F external force. Then directly proportional to, for what directly proportional to what? Rate of change of momentum. Then what I can write, rate means we can write the d by dt. Then what I can write here, dp. So then if I remove the proportional constant, then what I can write, f external is equal to k into dp by dt. So this is the formula. Or else what we can write directly, F is equal to ma. Okay, now I am going to derive the Newton second law.